Summing up the whole action of the klystron. The electrons coming from the cathode enter the first resonator with high kinetic energy. This first resonator is set into oscillation by the input signal so that the beam is modulated and bunches are formed in the drift space. These bunches, in turn, set up an electromagnetic field of the same frequency in the second resonator. Summing up the whole action of the klystron. The electrons coming from the cathode enter the first resonator with high kinetic energy. This first resonator is set into oscillation by the input signal so that the beam is modulated and bunches are formed in the drift space. These bunches, in turn, set up an electromagnetic field of the same frequency in the second resonator.
Bunch of particles, and then we turn up the field, and lo and behold, they all pile into this clump of ions, and they're moving like crazy. They're actually rotating around in what we call a trapnado. And then we turn up the field, and lo and behold, they all pile into Now here's a fun thing you can do. And that's these extended orbits
down, and we just put in lots of particles here.
We call a trapnado. And then we turn up the field, and lo and behold, they all pile into this. And I describe it a little in the documentation. What's happening is you excite particles into these extended orbits, and they're moving round and round and round, orbiting around the center line, and that produces a bit of a fan effect. It blows air out, and when you blow air out, the sides, it pulls in from the center. And it actually, the air currents keep those ions connected together in this knot. And it will just sit there oscillating away. And you see occasionally particles can get sucked in. I've put a few more in over here on the side. And you see them getting pulled up and just sucked into the trapnado. It is a little like a tornado in that it involves air currents. Okay. Now, if I turn it down, then it just goes back into a bunch of particles, and I turn it